merits of the cases.
Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says former Bureau of Corrections Chief Gerald Bantag has sent surrender feelers to one of the cabinet members several days ago. Bantag, along with his deputy Ricardo Zulueta, are facing two counts of murder for the separate killings of broadcaster Percy Lapid and Jun Villamor, an inmate who served as middleman in recruiting the gunmen.
He spoke to one of my colleagues in the cabinet to say that he may wish to surrender. That's why we are not pushing for law enforcement to hurry up the process. But of course, it is the job of law enforcement still to enforce the warrant of arrest.
Remulla adds, Bantag did not give any conditions for his surrender.
Alam mo, mahirap magtago. Mahirap magtago sa batas. It should be very difficult.
Remulla believed that Bantag is still in the country. A hold departure order was issued against Bantag after warrants of arrest were released by the Las Piñas and Muntinlupa RTC. The self-confessed gunman in the Percy Lapid killing, Joel Escorial, has been transferred to a more secure facility. After spending 6 months in detention at the Regional Special Operations Group at the National Capital Region Police Office in Taguig. From the NCRPO, he was brought to the PNP Custodial Center in Camp Crami in Quezon City. On Wednesday, a Las Piñas court granted the motion to transfer custody filed by ARSOG Chief Police Lieutenant Colonel Wilfredo C. She argued, Crame can better ensure Escorial's safety, adding that they don't have a detention facility that is secure enough to protect a high-value inmate.
Well, it's a safe place, maprotektahan siya doon. And kung ano man yung plano sa kanya ng gobyerno to make him a state witness, doon ang pagdesisyonan. And likewise, mga lock-up cell lang kasi ang mga detention namin dito.
Escorial welcomes his transfer.
Mas okay ako doon sa ano, sa custodial. Mas safe ako doon. Opo. Kaysa dito sa kung saan ng mga facility. Kung doon ako mapunta sa ibang facility, sigurado mawawala ako sa mundo.
Dahil?
Marami na nag-aabang sa akin eh.
He also expressed regret over his role in the murder. Escorial also explains why he took on the job.
Yun nga siya, yung sinasabi niya na ayusin daw yung ano nila doon sa loob para mapabilis daw yung ano nila, paglaya.
He again pleads for forgiveness from the Mabasa family. And to make things right, he said he's ready to testify in court. Escorial will be temporarily detained in Camp Crami's custodial facility while the case is ongoing. Jeff Caparas, ABS-CBN News.